Hey guys, Dylan from the Geek Door here, and today I'll be bringing you my reaction to Erased Episode 8, titled Getaway. It turns out that Keo, absent from school, has disappeared after all. Satoru is tormenting himself with the thought that he should have been able to do something more. On top of that, A.N. Nakanishi from the nearby elementary school has vanished too. Okay, so at the end, in the last episode, Satoru managed to get Keo to her birthday, which is the day after she originally got taken, well, not taken, killed, and left under the snow in the park. And he figured that because he made it past that day with her still alive, then history should have been better and change the future. However, when he showed up to class the next day, she wasn't there. So, and I went into this big spiel at the end of, yeah, in things like this, there is the option that history is preset. It will write itself eventually. Think of what Sir Night Eye said in My Hero Academia, if you watch that, when he was explaining his quirk to the assembled heroes. That is the logic that I was going off of. I don't know if that's true or not. It seems to be, because I think Aya was another of the three names from the book. Well, the book on crime. I don't exactly know what to call that, but yeah, so it seems that he may have saved her for one day, yet the next day two people disappeared. So he may well have to keep an eye on all three of them till the end of winter. But who knows if that's the case. We'll get this started in 3, 2, 1, go. Kid is always watching him. Look like her lying on the ground, but so I'm assuming her mum found her this time immediately, but when could it have happened? Like, because he said it snowed the night before, meaning it had to have happened that morning. However, that was the back of the house, so how would, and it was only leading away from the shed, not to it or anything like that, so Unless that was done as a diversion from the involvement of him. I'm starting to think that I don't actually know who did it, because nothing is leading towards that person even being a suspect, so. Lying to all of them about where she's gone so they don't know that she's disappeared. Okay, so it wasn't the same day. You don't have a guardian with you. The exact same story. Soon comes the third. the hell was that? Where did you run to? You're back in the future. Based on the blood on your hand, everything happened the exact same way. Oh, I thought he was going to go back on command there. So it seems, based on the start of this episode, that the person that she was on the phone to before she was killed was her old contact from the news. You haven't heard? Oh. Where'd they show a close-up of the Last Supper? This is feeling like a sting. How did the guy that was looking that way not see? It's your... Was on the piece of paper that was on the back of his phone. They made note to show that. Did he pick that up in the apartment or? I see why she has such an important part in the opening now. Not the first. So, oh yeah, no, their birthday was the second and it was the morning after. Yeah, that he did change a little bit. Why was her name different than... be followed, aren't you? Still immature, he's hoping to play her. You don't think it's related? We forgot the pizza. People like to say that to him. Really gonna burn the house down? Out the window. Straight out the window. I don't think you can make it out the window anymore. So I'm assuming it's the guy who was talking to the manager. Which, no, it leads away from the implied suspect to what I've been told, yet there's nothing. There's only the stuff in the present day to lead it to being that person. There's nothing in the past. But then again, why would there be anything in the past to... You'd think there'd be at least a little bit. Unless it's going to come in future episodes. Because, well, you'd assume he'd have to go back into the past again. But there's also the fact that how did her mum find her body if it was done this... How could the person that I have been told that it is, A, get to her in the time that it is implied that she was taken, And B, how would the mother have found the body to have brought into the house for... Unless she had something to do with it. But everything is implying that it's not. Unless, of course, it is him, and it's just that he's changed his look from... I'm trying to be as vague as possible with this, while also getting my initial thoughts out, because, well, as I said, I believe that I know who it is, because I was told who it is. There are things that are really throwing that into question. Hello. I just don't know what to think. Yeah. Anyway, I am thoroughly confused at the moment, so should probably end this one here before I just continue going in a circle, but I guess, so yeah, I'll catch you in the next one.